Hello. Hope you're doing well. Don't call it a comeback because it is. No, I think it is. It is a bit more this time, but let's get into the video. The Fallout Iceberg Part 2. So, this time around, I'm gonna take the ideas into mind from the last video in the comment section with the confidence meter. I'm gonna add this. So that'll be a feature in this video, and second of all, yes, I will change the music. I think there was another thing mentioned. Was show more of the iceberg itself? Yeah, we can do that as well. So yeah, let's get right into it. The platinum chip. The platinum chip was designed by Robert House and was printed at great expense in Sunnyvale on October the 22nd, 2077. If you couldn't tell, I'm reading from the Fallout Wiki. I'll put that in the description so you can look at some more. It became lost following the nuclear holocaust after the survivor regains consciousness from his coma after saving Las Vegas from full nuclear destruction. Mr. House spent millions of caps to find it. Around late 2281, the platinum chip was finally located by one of these scavenger teams. Cautious about its arrival, Mr. House first had delivery paths, avenues, and routes screened prior to having it sent to New Vegas via the Mojave Express, along with five other dummy packages of various novelty items so as not to convey its importance to anyone like the Raiders of the Brotherhood of Steel. These platinum chips would be carried by the courier from southern NCR through the hub to New Vegas. But as we all know, the chip was intercepted by Benny around Good Springs after attaining the exact route through Yes Man. The House's protege intended to use it to gain control of the New Vegas Strip and make it independent power in the wasteland, free of its employers' machinations. The only locations on Earth that have the computer hardware necessary to read the chip are inside the Lucky 38 Casino and a weather monitoring station on Fortification Hill. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure it's just referring to the chip itself, the story that we all know too well. Things of other note, you can get the chip working with Caesar or killing him. Could be referring to the glitch that you could obtain two platinum chips. First one from Benny, then one from Caesar, so that kind of defeats the whole purpose of the game. Yeah, but just a pretty well-known one. Moving on. Okay, so secondly, I know I didn't have the confidence meter in the last one, but that one's pretty well known. It's just one that everyone knows about, so it's real. I mean, it's there. It's the chip. I don't think I need to explain myself on that one. But secondly, Sean is father. Now, over the years, a lot of people have thought that. A lot of people think that he actually isn't father, and he's just a synth himself. I think that's what it's referring to. I don't know. I mean, the big argument for it is that the game makes no reference to him being a synth. That's a lot. That's all I can really find on it. And the time dilation, he got pulled out of the cryogenic chamber. I don't know how many years it was. It was when the synths came around, so I think it's possible. So I'm gonna say the confidence meter is pretty high in that one. But a lot of people, still think Sean isn't father, but I think it's pretty possible. Yeah, moving on. As we go deeper and deeper down the iceberg itself, we stumble across food paste from Fallout 4, the good old food paste. With a shelf life of over 100 years and past 200 years, allegedly it tastes delicious, but is apparently addictive and causes raiders to display even more extreme aggression after extensive consumption. It even turns ghouls pink. I'm not sure what the ice. I think it's just like pointing it out. So it's 100% true. I think the side effects is what the iceberg's trying to point out. And I'd say the confidence meter in this one's about 95%, if I'm going to be honest. It's definitely doing some damage, but I'll read a little bit more to the background of it. Formulated and produced by the Voltec Corporation in conjunction with the United States government, this food was a substitute and was put through a trial run in the Suffolk County Charter School as an experiment to help fund the school through a program called the Nutritional Alternative Paste Program, or for short, NAPP. The paste was intended to provide sufficient vitamins, minerals, and micronutrients. Furthermore, long-term consumption would also give anyone a complexion, the consumer, a pinkish hue, which I'm guessing means skin. So raiders can become addicted to it, and I think this one's referring to just how crazy it was that they were putting some, paste, trying to get away with feeding kids barely anything, and then in the long run getting them addicted and turning their fucking skin pink. But anyway, moving on. As we go deeper and deeper, we come across the fuck you door. In Fallout 3, near SATCOM array NN03D, it's pretty much a satellite dish that broadcasts. There's a fake door near the cliff face off to the right, I believe, of the satellite, and I think you need 100 lockpick to open it, right? And as soon as players figured out open it, got their 100 lockpick, they're like, damn, there must be something in here, right? They pick the door open, and what does it say? Fuck you. Confidence meter on this one is 100%, because it is what it is. That's all there is to it. That's a cool little, one of the funniest things that I think, hidden things you could find in the game. It wasn't really hidden, but anyway, moving on. We come across the new plague. The new plague is an infectious disease and socially transmitted plague which first arose in the 2050s within the continental United States. The epidemic became the driving force behind Pan Immunity Virus Project, which paved the way for development of the forced evolutionary virus. It was so widespread that a national quarantine was mandated in 2053. In 2055, West Tech started to develop a cure for the plague, establishing West Tech Research Facility. The government used the paranoia surrounding the virus to discourage assemblies, fuel anti-communist sentiment, and encourage informing government forces of suspected subversive elements. The government further used the new plague to register civilians, claiming a symptom of the plague was socialist thoughts and advocating isolation. People should stay indoors, read books, and avoid ice cream socials, quote unquote. Citizens were told if they believed they were infected, they would contact the disease control center, such as a disaster relief outpost in Point Lookout. West Tech was ultimately unable to develop the cure, despite the close ties of the federal government and their work in viral research through the Pan Immunity Virus. The subsequent FEV projects, control of West Tech Research Facility, were handed over to the military in 2071. Appearing in 2053, the illness killed approximately 200,000 citizens in the continental United States. It also went by the name of the Blue Flu and Limit 115. Due to the rapid spread of death toll and throughout the country, a national quarantine was put in by the end. Okay, we already read that. Second outbreak occurred in 2062, fueling national paranoia. It took until 2077, a third outbreak occurred, and the FEV research was leaked to the world through an unknown source, which led to the widespread protest in many major cities governments around the world, as well as accusations that the US... Ah, okay, so the US responsible for the new plague in the first place. Sounds familiar. I'm not going to go on with that. That's a really deep, interesting one, in my opinion. It is what it is. It has very deep roots in the Fallout lore, and explains how the FEV came around. So maybe this one's referring to, do I believe that the new plague was as bad as it was? Well, obviously not. The confidence meter is pretty low, actually, if we're gonna rate it like that. But did the bring it about themselves? I'm gonna say the confidence meter is pretty high from what I've read. So this is some stuff from Van Buren, but I'm guessing, because that's the beta Fallout 3, if you guys didn't know. I'm guessing that's kind of canon, but I'll leave it in the video anyway. So anyway, we'll be moving on. We're moving on to the original design for Mr. House from Fallout New Vegas. The picture explains for itself. The confidence meter is 100. It was in some of the original, you know, designs and pictures and things they released for the game. What do they call that? I can't think of the word right now. But yeah, the confidence meter is 100. Creepy. I'm glad they changed it. Maybe they changed it because it looked too much like Walt Disney, I'm gonna be honest. I know we've had that meme in our Podoxu cast about how we're guessing that, you know, Mr. House was a reference to Walt Disney. But anyway, moving on. Okay, the true creator of Jet. Jet is a drug in the Fallout universe, which it pretty much, I think it slows down time, if that's the right one. Well, Jet is a highly addictive metamine commonly found throughout the wasteland. It is extracted from Brahmin during fumes and commonly administrated via an inhaler. Brahmin are like the cows, so shit. Although first available before the Great War in different form, in the first half of the 23rd century, Myron developed Jet into a highly marketable commodity and tool for the enslavement of Redding by the Mordinos of New Reno. Even after the death of Myron and the subsequent fall of the Mordorinos from relevancy, Jet's availability, replicability, and popularity developed expansionally, whatever that means. I didn't go to school. The introduction of Jet antidote would barely slow its wide effects and appeal on the both West Coast and East Coast of the former United States. But as to the OG creator of Jet is an inhaled drug. Yeah, it was the invention of Chris Avellone, inspired by his brother's asthma inhaler. Avellone also posted in the Fallout Bible that Mrs. Bishop's claim been hooked on Jet by John Bishop before they were married, which subsequently resulted in her exile from Vault City. Could be due to her married to her memories being warped by the drug abuse. So I'm guessing this Chris Avellone, which, yeah, is one of the OG writers, so I'm thinking it's referring to him. So confidence meter is pretty high, but I don't know, it's a full team, so I don't know if that's just referring to the guy that actually read it. Yeah, so I think it's, they're wondering whether it's pre-war or after-war. So it's obviously pre-war, but it didn't become really popular until post-war. So I get the conspiracy there. No, it's confidence meters 100%, as in, or 0%. I guess I should say, is it's not really a conspiracy, it's just what it is. But anyway, moving on. So now that we're very deep, the number station debacle, or Fallout 3 predicted Deepwater Horizon. Now, Deepwater Horizon is a movie, but I guess it's referring to the event that happened as well. It happened in 2010, I think, in Louisiana, at an oil rig. Yeah, it was terrible. I think it was millions of gallons of oil went in the ocean. Fucked the Gulf for years. Fish are still pissing out oil, I think, but enough of the memes. Now, I'm pretty sure... Now, it's someone drew the line in on a Reddit post years ago, and I found something on Fallout Wiki which had been deleted. So this conspiracy is already at 100%. So even the guys at Fallout Wiki are deleting these posts. So let's get into it. Okay, this is going to go for a little while. So, occasionally the radio DJ, which is Three Dog, will transmit a series of numbers which sounds like Morse code. Supposedly, the code predicted the time and date of the explosion of Deepwater Horizon oil rig, as well as, the death of Queen Elizabeth II. Basically, if you kill Three Dog, his assistant Margaret will take over. She cannot be killed, as she doesn't appear in-game. Now, if the right prequisitists are met, there is still some debate as to what these are, such as killing Three Dog, not extending GNR signal range, and blowing up Raven Rock, something odd will happen. Directly after escaping Raven Rock and blowing it up, you will lose the option to pick GNR as a channel at all, and it'll reappear. Now, if you go onto one of the spots where you can actually listen, you will hear something rather chilling. Eric Todd Dellums, Three Dog, will list in a monotone, out-of-character voice, a string of numbers, then a message tapped in Morse code will be released. What is odd, that Three Dog is dead, yet you hear his voice act to say these random numbers in a completely monotone voice. It's eerie to say the least. I think Three Dog mentions that first, there's accident in the Gulf, several dead, oil spill adverted. Quote unquote, that's what he said. Which ties into 2010s, Deepwater Horizon catastrophe. Someone had decoded one of the messages that predicted the death of the musician. The weird part, the numbers that preceded the message were a date, the exact date the musician ended up dying. And then, quote unquote, what are you talking about? You'll be missed. The first half pertaining to Gary Coleman's iconic catchphrase, and the letter weirdly acknowledging the actor's death, though that also wouldn't happen until May 2010. So, that's what was said in Morse code and numbers, just your normal conventional codes. And the dates were also in Morse code and numbers, so crazy, huh? Anyway, moving on, we've spent far too long on this one. So, the moon DLC. Now, the moon is mentioned in all the games. You can see the moon at night. The moon still is relevant to this fictional world that they live in. But, obviously. Now, I'm pretty sure it's alluding to that the moon was supposed to be a deal, like I just said. Just shut up and keep talking. The location was mentioned in the design documents for the cancelled Van Buren project. Like I said earlier, it was the beta for Fallout 3. And there's a lot of things that have alluded to maybe one day going to the moon. It's in all the propaganda pieces in the museums. There's the Zetans and maybe they're hiding out in the moon. It's possible that the Enclave had a foothold in the moon as they had a space station. And it's something people have wanted for a long time. Now the conspiracy behind it, I guess it's halfway because you think about it, they were gonna do something with it in Fallout 3's beta, then they didn't do it, and they keep referring to it. So, maybe we will get that moon DLC, maybe for the next game, maybe, I don't know, maybe we won't, not, but, that's all I could find on the moon, honestly. Okay, now we're at the bottom, we're in the deep waters. Benny is sentient. Now, Benny is probably the main antagonist, or a secondary antagonist, in Fallout New Vegas. He has good qualities, bad qualities. He's mostly a piece of shit. I kill him each time. That's not here nor there. Keep talking, you dumbass. Keep going. Okay. I think this refers to all the bugs, and I literally couldn't find anything else. He's sentient. I think this must have been an old Reddit post, as they all are. But the amount of bugs he has, and the amount of, like... New Vegas is such a beautiful game when it comes to this, because there's so many options and so many things you can do. But he like, breaks all the rules. He has so many bugs, and does so many of his own things. If you know what I mean, like, the bugs, bugs, I guess, that people start to believe he's sentient. I've seen some Reddit posts alluding to that. And, I don't know. I guess he is. He might be behind you right now. There is someone walking behind you. Turn around. But I think that'll do. Part 2. I know it was 8 months in between. Sorry, not sorry. But I'm not calling this a comeback, because it's not. We're just going to do what we're going to do, and you'll see, because we're going to do some more things. I think the more we say that we're going to, you know, we're going to have a comeback, we're going to do this and that, we get more. No. I don't know if we can be bothered, so... Thanks for watching the video for this long. I know I'm a bit... I don't really care that you made it this far or not, but no, I genuinely do. That's a meme. But yeah. Have a fantastic morning, afternoon, evening, and I'll catch you on the flip side. Thanks for watching the video. Part 3 will come one day. It's just, yeah. Thank you.